Hello, I'm Brian Conrad. I'm the Cybersecurity Program Manager with the FedRAMP PMO, and I'm here today with Andrew Linz, our cybersecurity subject matter expert, who supports us on the program. And I'm here to talk to you today about FedRAMP's transition to NIST 853 Rev5. FedRAMP uses the National Institutes of Standards and Technology 800 series special publications to provide standardized security requirements for cloud services. Specifically, FedRAMP leverages NIST's special publication 800-53, Security and Privacy Controls for Federal Information Systems and Organizations series, including the baselines and test cases. NIST recently released their fifth revision, or Rev5, of special publication 800-53, which is the Security and Privacy Controls for Federal Information Systems and Organizations. They also released special publication 853B, which is the control baselines for information systems and organizations. FedRAMP is now in the process of revising all applicable FedRAMP materials to align with NIST's Rev5 updates. And in this video, we'll provide an overview of FedRAMP's Rev5 transition plan.
Hi, I'm Andrew Linz, and I'll walk us through the high-level steps for the transition plan. We are currently in step one, where we are reviewing NIST SP 853 Rev5 and draft updates to the FedRAMP baselines, high, moderate, and low. During this step, FedRAMP and the JAB will work together to determine the necessary updates to the FedRAMP baselines, parameters, and control guidance. During this step, we will solicit input from various government stakeholders. After we've completed our updates, we move into step two, release draft FedRAMP baselines for public comment. FedRAMP will publicly share the draft updates with our stakeholder community to review and provide comments and feedback. We will also work with our government partners to gather their input. Based on the extensiveness of the updates on the baselines, the public comment period could range from 90 to 120 days, but the PMO will ensure there is adequate time for all interested parties to provide comments. Next, in step three, FedRAMP will update the baselines and documentation based on public comments. During this phase, FedRAMP will review and adjudicate public comments and update the FedRAMP baselines and associated documents, templates, and guidance accordingly. FedRAMP will also be developing OSCAL versions of the Rev5 baselines to allow OSCAL-enabled applications to import the baselines. Throughout this phase, FedRAMP will also be working with the JAB and other government partners to ensure alignment on final updates. Finally, step four, FedRAMP will release the Rev5 FedRAMP baseline documentation updates and a CSP implementation plan. This release will include the final version of the FedRAMP updated baselines, including the OSCAL versions, associated documentation and templates, an implementation guide identifying the compliance timeline. The implementation timeline is dependent on the NIST release of the final updated version of SP 853, assessing security and privacy controls in federal information systems and organizations, building effective assessment plans. FedRAMP will use this document to update the FedRAMP test cases in order for test cases to be properly conducted. FedRAMP recognizes that this transition cannot be completed overnight. We will provide sufficient time to implement and test these updates and provide guidance on many of the new controls, many of which are focused on supply chain. Additionally, FedRAMP will provide frequent communications on updates and transition process and will be available to answer questions.
Throughout this transition, FedRAMP will be incorporating lessons learned and best practices from our Rev4 transition to ensure an efficient and clear transition. A large focus of ours will be frequent and clear communication and collaboration. FedRAMP will be developing an implementation plan in conjunction with CSPs and other stakeholders to provide CSPs the appropriate time and resources to migrate effectively and efficiently. We will release updates to the CSP Rev5 implementation plan as they are developed, solicit feedback, and provide plenty of time for stakeholders to implement required changes. I encourage each of you to review the updates when they are released for public comment and provide input. If you have any questions about the updates or our transition approach, please don't hesitate to reach out to info@fedramp.gov and make sure to sign up for our listserv to get all of our updates on this process. The link to sign up can be found at the bottom of any fedramp.gov webpage. We look forward to working with you all through this process. Thanks for listening.